guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. My name is Roxanne Spence and I'm a real estate agent in the Nashville, Middle Tennessee area with Realtor Realty Group. And today I am going to talk about one of the most asked questions that I get from people who are thinking of moving to Tennessee, and that is about tornadoes. What is going on with the storms here? I know on the news you hear all kinds of scary stuff, and I can share my firsthand experience. Having moved here from California 5 years ago, I've learned a lot along the way. So let's dive in. Okay, so tornadoes. So moving from California, I had no experience with tornadoes. I mean, California, the weather is pretty mild, you know? And I also was under the misconception that tornadoes really only occurred in areas where it was flat land and farmland and Oklahoma and Kansas. I watched Wizard of Oz. That's, I guess, where I got my information from. I don't know. I just never had any firsthand experience with tornadoes or really severe storms. So when we were moving to Tennessee, we already had some family living out here, and they kind of started to reveal that, you know, the storms were getting a little bit gnarly sometimes. Honestly, we weren't scared off by it. I would say never enter this move coming from a place of fear. The one thing I've learned is just inform yourself, get educated, and learn how to adapt, because everywhere has something. There's always going to be something, whether you move to Florida and there's hurricanes, or you move to California and there's a drought or flooding, apparently. The storms in Tennessee are really nothing to be scared of. Don't let that affect your move, because this great state has so much to offer. So I have had clients ask me, when we are in the house hunting stage, to try to find them homes that are not in an active tornado area or where there's the least amount of tornadoes. And my response to that is always, you're gonna need to do some of your own research. If you are concerned about tornadoes and weather patterns and you need statistics, by all means, research it. Because I would never want to give you information or sway you one way or the other based off of my own experience and come to find out that a tornado hits there in 3 years, because that can happen. When I first moved here, I never thought we could get a tornado in downtown Nashville, but we did. And I never thought that one would hit in Mount Juliet, but it did. And where we are now, it's pretty hilly. We have waterways around us. I never thought tornadoes could hit this area. They can. One 20 minutes away from us a couple years ago. But definitely do your own research and get informed. So when you're in the house hunting stage, it's really good to pay attention to where the safe space in that house is going to be. Does this house have a safe space? Is this house going to provide the protection that you need in the event of a really bad storm? So the rule of thumb with tornadoes is you need to have a safe space, preferably on the, you know, closest to the middle of the home, a room without windows, and somewhere that also doesn't have any exposed utilities or wiring or anything like that. So under a stairwell, a bathroom with no windows, a pantry, things like that. You can also go to a basement. Now, a basement is a great spot, very popular area for people to go in, you know, when you're under tornado watch. The only thing I would say is try not to huddle like right next to a water heater or something like an electrical panel. If something were to break, something were to bust from inside the home or outside, I just think it's better to be away from those utilities or as far away as you can possibly be. Some of the new construction homes actually have designated rooms, or it may have a bathroom or a pantry that actually has already also been reinforced. Some of them have cinder block that have been built around those rooms. If you're coming out here and you're building a home, you can ask your builder about that. You can also actually invest in storm shelters that can be placed in the home, outside the home, in the basement. So there's a lot of different options. But just make sure that the home you're looking at has a safe space that you can go to. Okay, so you found a home, you have a safe space, you're in Tennessee, and you experience your first tornado warning. Well, how are you actually going to know that you're under tornado warning or tornado watch? In some cases, you'll get a text message from the local weather station. I also like to download a couple weather apps because you can get notified that way as well. The Nextdoor app also has a feature that notifies me if there is a severe weather warning in our area. So weather apps, great idea. I believe they will also send out text messages. I'm not sure if it happens every time for every storm. I'm not sure if the storm has to hit like a certain level of severity in order for a text message to go out to all residents in that county, but I have received those texts in the past. Some cities also have tornado sirens, so you may hear those going off, especially in Nashville. I know that they do have sirens out there. Actually, the next town over has sirens. We don't in Burns, but I know that they do out there. And then the other thing that you're going to want to do is acquaint yourself with Danielle Breezy. So you may be asking, who is Danielle Breezy? Well, I don't know. This might be personal preference of mine. She's the local weather person on, I believe, Channel 4. And she's amazing. She is pretty much the person they call to come on the air whenever there's a severe storm. It always seems to be Danielle Breezy, and she does a great job. She will give you a play-by-play of everything that is going on with that storm, with that tornado, and she's really good about zooming in on the specific areas. She's really good at predicting things. When I'm in our safe space, it's in our pantry, I'll have the TV on in the background, and I've got Danielle Breezy on, and she's walking us through everything, play by play, everything that's going on with that storm. And I remember one time, it was probably 6 months after we moved here, we were under tornado watch. They will actually bring up, if there's like a, you know, pretty strong system forming, or they've already actually seen the tornado form, and it's maybe already touched ground in one spot, they'll bring up like a box, a purple box, and they'll put it over the area where they predict it's going to go next. And I remember we were in the purple box one time, and it was a little stressful. It was our first time. I had a 6-month-old. We were going into our safe space for the very first time, so it was a little nerve-wracking, but we had Danielle on TV, and she was literally going street by street, saying, if you're on this street, take cover now. I mean, if that's the best you can ask for in a scenario like that, someone who is literally going to be there talking you through it, through the storm, keeping you informed. So, and also in the event that power goes out, I recommend following Danielle Breezy on Facebook, because she's really good about also going on Facebook Live and recapping what she just covered on the news. She'll come back and do it on Facebook Live as well. So that's really great. And she will actually answer questions in the chat that pop up when she's on Facebook Live as a storm is going on. So she's a great resource. I'm sure there are other weather people at other Nashville stations that are also just as spectacular. But yes, we do have a special place in our heart for Danielle Breezy. One good thing to keep in mind too when you are in your safe space is I like to bring in pillows and blankets and throws. I think anything to keep you comfortable, but also to provide more protection, warmth in worst case scenario, that's a good thing to have. Also, if you have dogs, make sure you bring them in. You don't want them getting spooked and running out and never seeing your dog again. I like to put the harness on our dogs and then also attach their leash and keep them secure. And in the event something bad really did go down, they would already be leashed. We can grab the leash and hopefully all would end up okay. Just bringing as many resources into your safe space as possible. Charged phones, charged iPads, if you have some food products in there, first aid kit, helmets, that sort of thing. One thing that I've also been asked about, a lot of homes in Tennessee have a crawl space. Now, a crawl space is the space under the house, not a basement, but it's from the ground, the space between the ground and the floor. And those vary, you know, they can be a foot high, could be 3 feet high. You can walk into some crawl spaces. They're not basements, but they're technically a crawl space. And I've been asked if that's a safe place that you can go in the event of a tornado. And I have talked to many well-informed professionals who have said, no, that is not a safe place to go. And the reason is, you have all your exposed plumbing, wiring, you know, HVAC, your ductwork is in there. If anything were to break or bust under the ground, in the house, get knocked over, whatever, and you have all those exposed elements, utilities right there, that could be a really bad scenario. So no, a crawl space is not an ideal place to go. But if you have a basement, that's different. But also within that basement, you wanna make sure that you're not standing right next to a water heater if you can avoid it, or an electrical panel or anything like that. So along with tornadoes, we can also get really severe thunderstorms, torrential downpour, and, you know, high wind gusts. Just last year, we had one day where the wind gusts got up to like 70 miles an hour, and I've never seen anything like that. We were not under a tornado warning or watch, but they were talking about this wind storm, and that was a little new, you know. But the thing with that, with wind gusts or anything, you know, with these severe thunderstorms, I would say if you know the storm is coming, try to get anything that could go airborne out of the scenario that is outside. So trampolines, they can go flying. I mean, make sure you can pack it down, put it in the garage. I don't know if they can be staked into the ground, but I know some real severe damage can happen when those trampolines go flying. Same thing with cushions on your front porch. I have run out because I see my cushions, my brand new cushions went flying, and I ran after them. It was a lost cause. You know, once I stepped 10 feet out my door, I realized, okay, whatever. I've had a coworker, her rocking chairs went flying off her front porch. Just anything that could go airborne, especially if you know you're going to have really high wind gusts, bring it in, secure it. Let's try to keep our neighbors safe as well. I will say, firsthand experience, the first storm was a little nerve-wracking. I'm just going to be brutally honest. But after that, I knew what to do. I knew what to do with my family. I knew what to do with my dogs. I knew what to do to keep us safe. I kept the TV on. I had Danielle Breezy on my phone too. I was ready to go. Nothing ever happened. Nothing ever came of the tornado warning. That's another thing. Just because you're under tornado warning or tornado watch does not mean it's gonna happen. Tornadoes, you know, I feel like they're watching the weather system. They're watching things that could potentially form into a tornado, and they're warning you of that. But it doesn't necessarily mean that one will happen. And just keep in mind, tornadoes are not happening every single day here. I would say, and don't quote me on exact numbers, but I mean, a few times a year we're under tornado warning. It's not something that I feel affected by in my everyday life. So I hope that calmed any anxiety that you might have about moving to Tennessee and what our tornadoes and storms are like. If you have any questions or any comments or any feedback on this video, I'm all ears. Please comment below. I'm happy to answer any other questions. You can also find me on Instagram at @TheRoxanneSpence. You can send me a DM. And I hope that this video was informative and helpful. And I will see you guys next time.